It's crazy how one chapter in the story that has 1,000 chapters can change everything for this fan base. What I mean by this is chapter 1,000 was an intense chapter, and the way it ended, a lot of people were discussing power scaling. And One Piece fans are known for getting their ankles broken by two ways. Either they get their ankles broken by a plot twist, which is the normal way, or power scaling in a chapter. When a chapter drops, they power scale. The next chapter, everything they said is the complete opposite, and their power scaling goes to the trash. Now, I'm not gonna act like I'm perfect. I'll be honest here. My power scaling mindset was destroyed after Katakuri and Luffy. My mindset before that battle was completely different to after that battle. This shows you, even me as a person who always talks about One Piece, can have their mindset changed because of a moment in Whole Cake Island, a moment that a lot of people like to put under the rug. Now, I do want to say this. I've been hearing controversial statements like, why is Luffy damaging a Yonko now when he couldn't damage a Yonko in Whole Cake Island? Why didn't Luffy damage Big Mom? Why didn't he defeat Big Mom? You gotta understand, Luffy came off a Doflamingo battle, went to Whole Cake Island to rescue Sanji, and pretty much that is a big difference right there. The fact that you go to Whole Cake Island, you have a different purpose than going to Wano, you're coming off a lesser fight than when you're going to Wano. Like, he came to Wano off a Katakuri battle. He came to Whole Cake Island off a Doflamingo battle. That's a huge difference. The purpose of trying to defeat Kaido to Wano to the purpose of Whole Cake Island trying to actually save Sanji just shows you, like, I'll be honest with you, if you go to the gym and you have a purpose of doing a new PR, or if you have a purpose of just working out, it's going to be completely different energy levels. That could be the same for this whole situation of Luffy. So I'm telling you guys right now, I'm going to power scale Luffy, the fifth emperor. I know that was controversy during the Reverie when that happened, but the fifth emperor, I'm going to power scale him. Is he truly Yonko level? I know that terminology, a lot of people don't like it, but let's actually discuss his scaling. Before you guys continue, make sure you guys subscribe and like this video. Let's try to get 500 likes for this video. The big thing is turn on notifications, because I don't want you to miss the crazy videos I have planned for this week. One Piece 2021, we're going on crazy level mode. Now, to power scale Luffy, I'm not going to go all the way to pre-time skip to look at Luffy's power. I'm going to go to the first time post-time skip, the new world, where Luffy actually tried. And the first time, me personally, I feel like Luffy tried was the Doflamingo fight. Yes, there was a whole Hody situation, but I feel like he tried more with the whole Noah than destroying the Noah than actually the Hody fight. Of course, Caesar, Zoro was yelling at Luffy because he wasn't trying, like he was getting taken else to Caesar, like Caesar of all people. But the first time Luffy actually tried 100%, I'm not gonna say fully 100%, but he tried his best to win a fight, was the Doflamingo battle. And I'll be honest with you, the Doflamingo battle, Luffy was way weaker than what he is right now. Luffy was getting help, of course, from his ally, Trafalgar D. Wattel Law, with the Gamma Knife that definitely injured Doflamingo pretty badly. Luffy, of course, used Gear 4th, but of course, his Gear 4th ran out. The Dressrosa Colosseum fighters helped out a little bit. Like, there was a lot of breaks in between the fight, but at the end of the day, Luffy's King Kunkun was devastating and was able to defeat Doflamingo. After this battle, Luffy definitely got stronger from defeating a legendary, the guy who known as Joker. Moving on, we go to the Cracker battle. Now, a lot of people like to throw the Cracker battle under the rug. Like, they don't like to mention the Cracker battle. They only mention Doflamingo and Katakuri because they're more badass, they're more cool. But I personally feel like Cracker was pretty badass. Like, that whole reveal shocked me. I remember, this is a point and an example I mentioned early in the video, how people changed their opinions after a chapter. When Luffy destroyed the Biscuit Soldier, everyone said Cracker was trash. The next chapter, Cracker cuts Luffy, everyone says Luffy's trash. That's how the One Piece fan base is. Ankles broken all the time, I'm telling you guys. But the Cracker fight, definitely Luffy, of course, was fighting him throughout the whole night, and then running away, then eating his biscuits, then fighting, then running away. Definitely wasn't like how a true 1v1 battle for Luffy. Just how Doflamingo, there was help. But still, at the end of the day, Tank Man was able to defeat Cracker. He got the help of Nami, of course, the homies. But at the end of the day, like I said, Luffy defeated Cracker. He defeated Doflamingo. I don't really care about the help. At the end of the day, the W, he got that. And these fights made him get stronger. Now let's get to the fight, which I said pretty much changed my whole mindset of power scaling. The reason why is because I see this first fight, he tried hard, Doflamingo, he got help. The second fight, he tried hard, Cracker fight, he got help. So I'm expecting Katakuri battle, he's gonna have some crazy help. And yes, Luffy got some help, but it wasn't crazy help. I actually feel like Luffy got more help in the Doflamingo battle and the Cracker battle than the Katakuri battle. But this fight was definitely longer, around 18 chapters. And I'll be honest here, this is why my power scaling mindset changed, because in this fight, there was a flashback from Rayleigh talking about what are you gonna do if you see someone who can see the future. Of course, in the anime, they show Rayleigh training Luffy in Gear 4th. They show, of course, situations of Rayleigh saying your haki gets stronger as you battle. And of course, Katakuri was beating Luffy the most. Like, Doflamingo and Cracker did not beat up Luffy as Katakuri did. Katakuri beat Luffy up for 18 chapters. His haki is definitely gonna get stronger on some Zenkai Dragon Ball Z stuff. But at the end of the day, Snake Man came out and Luffy barely won. I know, I'll be honest here, it felt like a draw, but Luffy barely won in my personal opinion. And this battle, after this battle, Luffy became immensely stronger. He's able to see future, he's able to do future sight. I definitely feel like Luffy definitely leveled up in this battle. And it's crazy how, like, the strongest opponent, he had the least amount of help. Just showing you, like, the less help you have, the more stronger you get, in my personal opinion. And these three battles were the major battles Luffy got before Wano. Now I bring up Kaido. I went from Doflamingo to the third Yonko commander of Big Mom to the vice captain of Big Mom to an actual Yonko Kaido. And I'll be honest here, Kaido one-shot at Luffy in Gear 4th. Like, that was an immense feat. Luffy did all his best attacks. It was definitely shocking, to say the least. I never thought Luffy would get one-shot in Gear 4th like he did. Like, I remember seeing Big Mom two-shot Queen, and that was extremely impressive to me personally, too, because Big Mom wasn't even, like, in her right state of mind. And when she did get in the right state of mind, Queen was panicking like hell. I feel like this personally just admits that Luffy was, after Hokage Island, Luffy reached Katakuri level. I feel like Katakuri and him were on the same level after Hokage Island. Like, in Prison of Udon, Luffy's pretty much saying, I want to fight you, Big Balloon. We know Queen is a top young commander of Kaido, the second young commander of Kaido. That's around, like, vice captain of an emperor, in my personal opinion. Like, they're around the same level. So I definitely want to say Luffy was at the Katakuri level. This kind of confirmed it with this Kaido battle. And I feel like this shows, it just honestly just showed me that a Yonko is just leagues beyond everybody else. The Yonko power is scary. So me saying this showed me that the Yonko power is scary makes you understand why a lot of people are so hesitant to make Luffy that title of Yonko level. Yes, we saw the whole Fifth Emperor stuff by Big News Morgan, but we all like that is Big Cap Morgan. I do want to say this, his haki training, in my personal opinion, was the most I've ever seen Luffy get stronger. He was learning advanced haki level 1 and advanced haki level 2. Like, these two levels of advanced are in the haki. He already had his future sight getting stronger as well. I feel like this definitely made him go in between a vice captain to an emperor to a Yonko. I didn't think he was admiral level, but I feel like he was in between that vice captain to an emperor to a Yonko. So if you guys do not know my scaling, I got Yonkos, I got admirals, then I got vice captain to an emperor. But of course, there are some rare situations where a vice captain to an emperor could be on the admiral level, there's some rare situations like that, in my personal opinion. But Luffy, I feel like he came to Wano and he was a Katakuri level, a vice captain to an emperor level, and after this training he became above a vice captain to an emperor. That's what I pretty much want to say. It definitely was shocking, to say the least. I remember him training against Big Mom. Hyogoro was like, yo, in a very dangerous situation your haki gets stronger, just like how Rayleigh said in crazy fights your haki gets stronger. Cool to see Luffy challenge the Yonko even though he got destroyed in Prison of Udon. But 2 weeks later, of 2 weeks of training, and people always like to say Luffy trained for 2 weeks, he got way stronger than his training with 2 years with Rayleigh, or 1 year and 6 months. I'm telling you guys right now, Luffy's not getting that strong without the 1 year and 6 months, guys. The 1 year and 6 months of training Luffy to get all the basics. You know, Rayleigh pretty much said that it's because you have Congress Haki, Arm Haki, and Observation Haki, I'm going to actually train you to be a balance of all three. I'm not going to train you in one set. Like, Rayleigh could have trained Luffy advanced Haki, but he said, nah, I'd rather him just train his Observation Haki and his Arm Haki. And of course, Congress Haki is going to get stronger as time goes on. And that's a big thing, guys. Those 1 year and 6 months of Luffy training with Rayleigh, just to get the basic foundation. Everybody knows, and even in real life situations, when you get the basics of something and then you train again up with already knowing the basics, of course getting stronger is gonna be way easier. That's why in the 2 weeks he got immensely more powerful than he did in the 1 year and 6 months. It's common sense when it comes to haki training. Now I know you guys are probably thinking, Mac, you gotta answer the question. Red Rock Luffy just came, he didn't even use Gear 4th, and he damaged a Yonko and Kaido. Regardless of how much he damaged Kaido, he still put some damage to Kaido, which is better than whatever we've seen Luffy do in the past. I'm gonna answer the question, guys. I don't think Luffy is Yonko level. I'll be honest here, I don't think Luffy's Yonko level. There's a reason why you Luffy, Kid, Law, Zoro, and Killer are there. There's five characters there to fight two characters. That's a 5v2, guys. I'm telling you guys right now, Luffy is not Yonko level. But I feel like Red Rock definitely was the biggest advancement we've seen to Luffy getting to Yonko level, and that scares me. I feel like right now Luffy is super close to admiral level, and I feel like after this fight against Kaido, regardless of how much help he gets, like we've seen in the past, Luffy after Wano will be admiral level. And once you're admiral level, there's only one more step to go. That's Yonko level. And that's, I feel like that's the easiest step. From admiral to Yonko is the easiest step. And once you get to, once Luffy gets to Yonko level, I feel like it's gonna happen like after Wano in a sense too. Like pretty, after Wano, Luffy's gonna get immensely stronger. EOS, he's gonna have to get to Pirate King level, because Blackbeard's gonna be doing some next level stuff in which you're gonna have to get to Pirate King level to defeat that three Devilfruit monster. I know Blackbeard's gonna be on some demon time with his Yami Yami no Mi and his other Devilfruits. I'm telling you guys right now, the hype is real for the One Piece story, and I'm extremely excited to get to the end of the story. Each order definitely made a message in chapter 1000 saying he's super close to the end of the story, so please just hold on a little bit more. And it's very, very, how to say this, it's very bittersweet. Like, I really want to see the One Piece. I really want to see the end of the story. I've been following the story for so long, but it's kind of like, it's kind of been ingrained to my lifestyle to read One Piece chapters, to look back on One Piece chapters, to watch One Piece. Like, to see it end would definitely be bittersweet. But that's pretty much my thoughts on Luffy's power scaling. Luffy is the fifth emperor. Now he's getting more claim. Like, it was cap during the Reverie, but now I feel like it's becoming slowly less cap. Luffy, his power scaling, like I said, I feel like he's super close to admiral level right now, just off that red rock. Like, a lot of people jump to the conclusion that he's Yonko level. No. I don't think he's Yonko level, but I think he's super close to admiral level. Like, after his Wano fight, I think he'll be admiral level, and Luffy's progression is going to be insane. But tell me your thoughts down in the comment section down below. What are your thoughts on this chapter? Did you enjoy it? Did you not enjoy it? I love reading you guys' comments. Of course, like and share if you enjoy. Like and share only if you enjoy. Subscribe for more One Piece content. I'm the Legend Mac, and I'm gone.